It's the sum, right? Sum, it's really the sum of the first n terms. First n terms. Right? What's a sub 1 mean? It's the first term, so you have down the first term. And then what's the r mean? Common ratio, right? The ratio is fine. Alright, and then finally the n stands for the number of terms. It's just the formulas rearranged a little differently, right? Same letters that have to do the same thing. So you have to understand or remember that it is the sum.
error versus if we just didn't do what they were doing. Because there's not a whole lot of in between on this commercial setting. So if you plug it in, you don't have to do it for, you know. All right, so the next one. There we go. All right, so I am going to start, but I know I have to do the sum, and it's finite. Thank you. why you need to check it every time. Okay? Had this been a zero here, or had that been an n minus 1, it would have been 4. Okay, so we got 4. Alright, so we got 1.2. 1 minus, what's the ratio? 0.3 to the 12th power over 1 minus 0.3. Okay? You typed it into your calculator. You got a decimal. Two answers are going to in some respects makes it easy, but you gotta know how to use the formula and what the formula is. Okay. Alright, we're gonna skip 15. We're just gonna go to some of the units and see if we skip 15. I told you when we go to take the test, it's going to be matching on the formulas. So you need to keep straight which one is the infinite and which one is the finite. Okay? So when it says infinite, notice, is there an n here? No, it's just s, so it's just sum. So you're adding up every single term in that series. Okay? So every term all the way to infinity. Okay? The reason it can be done, I can't explain because I think it's done. Okay? But just know that it can be done. Okay? What's a sub 1 stand for? That's still your first term. Okay? And the R stands for common ratio. Now, there's a catch with this. The R value, the absolute value of it has to be less than 1 in order for us to be able to make this sum. Okay? If it's not less than 1, the absolute value of 1, then you can't do it. Remember, the absolute value of 1 means it would really be between negative 1 and 1. So if I had an R value that's equal to 2/3, that's okay. If I had an R value that's equal to negative 2/3, that's okay. But if I had an R value that's equal to 3/2, can I use that one? It's not between negative 1, so that means it would not have a sum. So we write no sum. Okay? It says you're doing sum of an infinite, your other clue, you see the little infinity up there at the top? Okay, so that means that that's the end, so you're going to pull out your sum of an infinite formula. So, S equals, I need A sub 1. So I'm going to find my A sub 1, so I'm going to calculate and put it just like I was doing on the other one. So 4 times 0.6. I wonder why I had that note here. I need to find the zero. Alright. So, Andy, what is anything with a zero power? 1, so I've got 4 times 1 or just 1. Had we left it the 1, it would have been 4. Okay? If not, then it would have mattered. We could still have. Alright, so my 4 is my a sub 1. 1 minus, what's the R value? 0.6. Is that between negative 1 and 1? That's okay, right? And I probably should check that first. Right? Okay. Let me pick them up until you're calculating. And these numbers, even though you're going to infinity, are actually going to be fairly small. Infinite, because not only certainly doesn't say it in the instructions, but it says affinity there, so I'm using S equals A sub 1 and then 1 minus R. Alright, to get A sub 1, I'm going to plug 1 into that. So 5 times 1 half to the first. That's just 5 halves. So could I use the 5 halves? Could I put it in decimal if I wanted to? Your choice, okay? That will be either way. I'm going to leave it 5 halves. Alright, 1 minus, what's my ratio? 1 half, whatever, to the parentheses. But remember, this is, you really, you're kind of like your a sub 1. I'm sorry, it might not be a sub 1, but that's definitely the ratio of the sub 1. So, 1 half. Okay, if you can do it, what's up, whatever. Yeah. to explain why you have to be governed by the word. But the reason is, so though Solomon, the reason is because R is greater than. Okay. All right. I believe that's it, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. So what we're going to do is tomorrow we're going to do the last thing for this. This was fast. That's 4 days. Okay. My goal is to be testing possibly by next Tuesday. It will either be Tuesday or Thursday. I'm not going to come up Wednesday. Okay. The other thing we're going to probably do next week is we're going to start taking some of the practice stuff for SBAC. Because you guys, SBAC has everything in coaching. That's the other thing we did. Okay. So we need to start exposing ourselves to some of that stuff that is actually going to look at that as well. After February break, we have logarithms. And then we're into trig, okay? And then along with coupling that with still practicing, getting those moments of the actual program and the big thing, it could be altitude.